Welcome to the Haunted Pavilion. Please stand as we honor our 2023 high school graduates of Ganado High School. Thank you.
Ganado High School graduation ceremony. I am Mrs. Sydney, the principal of Ganado High School. At this moment, I'd like to invite up Ms. Aldondria Jody to provide the welcome address.
Good afternoon, everyone. Yat Esh E Aldondria Jody Yisha. Look at the name, Mishlan. Nasht Esha Tapa Hambashishchi. Not Odene Tachini Dashiche. Glasche Dashinella. Shema E. My latest mother, Alvina Nez. Do Brianna Jody Woolya. Shija E. Melvin Jody Woolya. Shema San Edo Shiche. A. Alta McCabe Do Irvin S. Senior will, yeah? Welcome, family, friends, and staff. I thank each and every one of you for showing up and taking that time to watch us pass into our beginning journey of our lives. It's good to see a lot of faces, the smiles, the joy, the laughter, and the relief being shown throughout this whole celebration. The motivation and support you parents gave us to push us to do better and to focus on the good things throughout our 4 years of high school. It's a blessing to receive and to cherish after you walk across the stage. We are also very proud of you as well. The belief you had in us and within this moment of appreciation is well given. We all said, oh, 4 years is going to go by slow. But after these 4 years has gone by, we're here now to walk into the face of reality, taking that full potential we had when we entered our freshman year. Who knew it would come by this fast, in a blink of an eye, to see ourselves succeed in the most passionate way? Not only did we just succeed in high school, we achieved the ultimate goal of pushing ourselves, testing our limits, overcoming our fears and obstacles through trials and tribulations. We don't get to experience this once because we learn something new every day, and it will add on to our growth in life. Having the strength to get up and try again doesn't waste time. It's a learning process to intake and remember. Life doesn't stop now. We have a new one beginning, and time doesn't wait for no one. Our parents have been waiting to see this day come, to pat themselves on their backs and say, yes, I had one job and I succeeded. And they say that with love. After all, we achieved something good today, and our hearts are filled with joy, nothing but positive energy surrounding us, and we all deserve that thank you. Within all this, I wish nothing but the best for us, the class of 2023. We don't come to an end, it's only the beginning. Yeah. Thank you, Aldondria. Please remain standing. Please welcome to the stage Ms. Ariana Holiday. Ms. Holiday is from Steamboat, Arizona, and is the current Ms. Ganado Intermediate School Princess. She was also the former 2019-2020 Ms. Ganado Primary School Princess. She is now in the fifth grade at Ganado Intermediate School and has been invited to perform the singing of the national anthem. And she has done this at many sporting events and other special events as well. We are very privileged to have her here today, and especially because today is her birthday. She is here with her escort, and she will now perform the national anthem.
Ya shoda no lai hayat kalbi eden bada wili goten dana dani egone hene lini na does the beside the sun. Yeah. das zosen de oshi en so bilsen go dana da hola do neheke ya Congratulations to all graduates. Nijoniye, you guys did good this year. Keep it up. Ada. Ada, ashin ishlido, tachi ni bashishin. Sitna jini e dashiche, toduchi ni e dashinella. E dacha kenishle. Nez nashna he doshla ishtra. Shema e ermaria tonsuan, yeah. Chija e Elmer Holland and Ahihat Anatwo Najaniyet do a good job this year. Good job.
Thank you very much, Miss Holiday. That was a very great performance, don't you all think? And again, happy birthday, Ariana. Please remain standing for the invocation conducted by Mr. Gilbert Tracy. Mr. Tracy is currently teaching science at Ganado Middle School. Please welcome him to the stand.
Thank you for inviting me in to offer a little request to the Lord about your ways and the days to come. Awesome job, guys. Let's bow in prayer. Father God, thank you for this day. It's a special day. We ask, God, that you will be with each family here of each student that has graduated and put in the years, Father. And it's amazing how they've grown, how they've become young men and women. Guide them in all their pathways. Let this day be very special, Father, that the families surrounding them will provide guidance and reminders. And I remember, Father, with my four kids joining in celebration at these times. And this world, Father, has been tough the last 4 years. Some have lost loved ones. And we ask, God, that we will always be mindful of prayer, to always seek you out. Wherever there's doubt, wherever there's darkness, just be our all today. Thank you for a good day. And bless all the families and these kids again. In Jesus' name I ask, amen.
Thank you, Mr. Tracy. You may all now be seated. At this time, I would like to introduce our esteemed platform guests. We have, starting at my left, Mr. Vince James, Ganado Council Delegate. Next, we have Mr. Alan Blacksheep, school board member, Ganado Unified School District. Next, Mr. Pat Burns, Ganado Unified School District board member. Mr. Macarlo Roanhorse, Ganado Unified School District board member. Mr. Wallace James Jr., Ganado Unified School District board clerk. Mr. Joseph Mora, the Ganado Unified School Board President. We have Ms. Joy Whiting, the Apache County School Superintendent. Dr. Leandra Thomas, the Ganado Unified School Superintendent. Mr. William McCabe from the Navajo Nation Office of Oil and Gas Company. Ms. Montoya, the Vice President of the Navajo Nation. To my right, Destiny Morgan, our keynote speaker for today. Ms. Ariana Holiday and her escort, Ms. Ganado Intermediate School Princess. Mr. McNabb, Chris McNabb, Assistant Principal, Ganado High School. Mr. Gilbert Tracy, Ganado Middle School Science Teacher. Mr. Robert Berkey, Ganado High School Math Teacher. Ms. Sarah Wilson, Ganado High School English Teacher. Ms. Claire Kuhl, Ganado High School Government and Economics Teacher. And Mrs. Loretta Smith, Ganado High School PE and Health Teacher. I thank all of you for being here today, and I appreciate your presence for our graduates and to see them meet this accomplishment. Thank you very much. Next, I am pleased to bring to the stage the senior class of 2023 president, Ms. Naomi Bluehouse. Ms. Bluehouse will address her classmates one last time as they embark on a new journey in their lives. Please welcome to the stage, Ms. Bluehouse.
Yat esh e Naomi Shandin Bluehouse inishye, ki ani nishle, sit na jini, bashishi, tabaha dashiche, kithlichini dashinele, shima doshije e jina ado rando Bluehouse, shima sona doshiche, Christine, do James Jones, shinela astan ado, shinela hastin, alta ado Homer Bluehouse. I'm from Ganado, Arizona. I'm 18 years old, and I'm the 2022-23 senior class president. Good afternoon, everyone. First, I'd like to start off with a congratulatory statement to my fellow classmates. We did it. We finished Ingenuity. I'm so proud of you all for getting here today to write to this very moment. I'm so happy I can share today with all of you. We have grown up together, and I've seen so many of you become the amazing person you are today. I'll be honest, for the last few weeks I've been putting off writing this speech, not only because I couldn't put any of my thoughts into words, but because when I finally did, it would mean our journey in the last 12 years of our lives together would be over. That within the few minutes I have, I'd like to share with you the very words that have kept me going and pushing myself when I felt like quitting school and just leaving everything I've worked so hard to accomplish go. I stand before you today as a representative of the four pillars of life. These people have shown me the way through their characteristics and guiding words. From my grandma Christine Jones, I learned that being a strong and independent woman and being opinionated and headstrong isn't a bad quality. It'll take you a long way in life. My grandpa James Jones always said, stay in school, learn something. Be something. If you just sit around and do nothing, your life will go nowhere. Get your education. You're smart. You can do anything you set your mind to. My Che James was a man of very few words. He didn't speak English much, but when he did, it always was the same words. Stay in school. Get your education. Where's the mokes? And is wrestling on. From my Nolly Elsa Bluehouse, I've learned that accomplishing hard work doesn't come easy, and nothing is handed to you. You have to work for it. And if you want something in life, you must grab a hold of it and never let it go. Although I've never met my Nolly man, the Honorable Justice Homer Bluehouse, I always hear about how he was kind, charismatic, and wise. From the stories I've heard about my Nolly Homer, I learned he was a leader and that he worked hard. I strive to be like him, not only in becoming a leader, but leaving my community proud. With their words and stories, With their words comes stories about the residential schools they attended and lectures about how they endured hardships so we can strive in this glittering world. So my fellow classmates, I pass these wise words of my family on to you and hopes you'll carry it with you in your life, on your journey, in this glittering world. These last few months as we've inched our way closer to today, I've had conversations with all of you. And we've all talked about college or going straight to work. I'd like to congratulate all of you and encourage you once again. I know each and every one of you has the ability to achieve greatness. And I believe in each and every one of you to continue in your future endeavors. Yego, Shiaja. I believe in each and every one of you. Yego, keep going, don't give up. It doesn't end here. You have your whole life ahead of you to make something of yourself. Next, I'd like to thank my parents for giving me the opportunity to be standing here with you today, along with supporting and encouraging me to finish. Thank you to my biggest supporter, my older sister. She's given me the materials to succeed and continue on with my education. And my most important supporter is my community and tribe. Thank you for standing behind me and encouraging me in my journey through life. Ayehet. I'd like to recognize my senior officers and representatives. When you hear your name, please stand. Lissandra Baldwin, Vice President, Senior Class. Calista Shepherd, Secretary, Senior Class. Ashton Apache, Treasurer, Senior Class. And our Executive Branch Officers, Alina Reed, President. Eliana Smith, Vice President. Shandeen Benali, Secretary. Mariah Lee, Treasurer. Julian Tubaha, Senior Class, Representative. Alessandria Jody, Senior Class, Representative. We, the senior class, would like to recognize a dear friend we lost a few years ago, Oscar Torres, who would have been here sitting with us today. We'll miss you and you'll forever be in our hearts. And no matter what, we still care for you and we miss you every single day. Now, I'll end with a quote from a man we all admire and respect very deeply, Mr. Berkey. We have matched the Gator Dunn key on high school.
Thank you very much, Ms. Bluehouse. It's a very inspirational message to our graduating class. Naomi, your leadership has definitely shined in all the activities that the senior class has participated in throughout the school year and in previous years as well. So thank you very much for that. Next, I'd like to welcome to the stage the Ganado Unified School District Governing Board President, Mr. Joseph Mora, who will address the class.
Got to get my glasses on, getting old over here. All right, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Joseph Mora. My first clan is Tachikni, born for Nakai. My ki ani is Shiche, Nakai Shinada. I am your school board president, and I'm also an alumni of Ganado High School, class of 1985. I'm from Ganado. I grew up here. My family used to own the Conoco, and Alon Station. And my parents, they're always told me and my family that you're gonna graduate from college. I have 7 sisters and 1 brother, and we all graduated from college. 5 have master's degrees, and we have a doctor in the family. And the reason I bring that up is that my parents, that's all they said was, you're gonna go to college, you're gonna graduate from college. And as parents, and as students that you're going to be going to college, I want you to remember that. You need to say to yourself, I'm going to college, I'm going to graduate from college. And that's what you're going to do. And that's what I wanted to emphasize, is that when you start telling yourself and you start believing in that, then you can make it happen. The second thing I want to let you know, tell you, is that you need to start is to believe in yourself. And to say, yes, I can do it. Yes, I'm able to do it. Don't let anyone say that you can't do something. Don't ever say you can't do this, you can't do that. You can't do this because you're from the reservation. You can't do this because you're Navajo. You can't do this because you came from where you came from. Don't ever let anyone say tell you that. Always say to yourself, I can do it, no matter what. You say that to yourself. And the third thing I want to tell you is to face your fears. Stand up for it. Even though you fear something, it'll make you stronger. And I'm going to tell you a little story, something personal about my life and how this was affected me. And when I say stand up to your fears, growing up, I was in college and I didn't want to go to college. And I'm kind of one that's kind of the black sheep. I said, no, I don't want to be in college. I don't want to be in college. I want to go to cooking and baking school. And I pleaded with my dad to say it was okay to go. And he said, yes, as long as you graduate from college one day. And I said, okay. And as kids and parents, and I'm a parent also, we want our, as children, we want to be proud, make our family proud. And I always wanted to make my dad proud of me because I was the second youngest. I never thought he cared that much about me. And my dad always growing up always talked about being a paratrooper, jumping out of planes. And so then they had the Gulf War started, Operation Desert Storm. So I volunteered and joined. I joined the infantry. I joined airborne. I wanted to make my dad proud, jump out of planes. But guess what? I'm afraid of heights. And everybody said, what are you doing? You're going to be jumping out of a plane. You're afraid of heights. And I'm like, well, that's something I got to get over. Because in my mind, like I said the first time, in my mind, I said, I'm going to do this. You're afraid of heights. You can't do this. Yes, I can do this. So I did it. I went through basic. I went through AIT. I went through 2-week airborne schools, 3 weeks. I went 2 weeks. My dad passed away. So I came home, went to the funeral, and I went back to the airborne school. And I went, and there's 5 jumps that you have to make in order to get your airborne wings, something like this. And I made 2 jumps. I did 1 jump, and it was great. The second jump, I got hurt really bad. I got knocked out. I landed wrong. And it was very dangerous, I finally found out. I hit my head, had blood all over my hands. I passed out. I blacked out. And I woke up with the medics and I was strapped to a table and they said, you know, you might be paralyzed, don't move. And I was 22 years old and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna be paralyzed. And then they took me to the hospital and then they said, yo, you're okay. You can continue on if you want because it's completely voluntary. I could have quit at that time because I know there was fear. But I told my dad and I said, you know, I'm going to go forward with this. And that's what you got to do sometimes. You know, you're now, when you think of yourself, think of your faith. Believe in yourself and pray. And that's what I did. And I went ahead and took the courage and I jumped again. I jumped 3 more times. I got my airborne wings. I said, all right, cool. I'm done. I'm not jumping anymore. Then guess what? oh, you're going to Italy, you're assigned to the 82nd Airborne, you're gonna be jumping all the time. I'm like, oh my gosh. And so I went, and I went overseas, and my mom was really afraid because we just had lost my dad. And so I was there, and we had, and I found out that jumping out of planes is dangerous. I had one of my two jumpers behind me. He passed away, he died in the jump. We had, I lost about a quarter of my unit in an airborne accident. Then I was in the door of a C-130 and I messed up. And I missed the drop zone and I messed up my legs and my knees and I got hurt again. But I continued on and I finished out my time. And that's what I mean. When you go, that fear you have, you might have someone to say, you know, I'm not sure if I can do this. I'm afraid to go talk. I'm afraid to go give a speech. I'm afraid to do something. You got to look within yourself and believe and say, yes, I can do it. And I can do this. And you will succeed. And parents and you that are here, you tell your children, yes, you can do it. You can do it. That's all it is. It's all in your mind. And that's the one thing I want to tell to you. Okay? I know you can go and you're going to go on to do great things. And I want to welcome you to the family of alumni, because now you are alumni of Ganado Unified School District, right? All of us alumni that are here, we welcome you. And if you ever need anyone, see, you have all that support. And I just want to say that. Also, Airborne, all the way, once a Hornet, always a Hornet.
Thank you, Mr. Mora, for that encouragement to our graduates. I appreciate that. Next, I would like to welcome Naomi Bluehouse back to the podium to introduce our keynote speaker for today.
Good morning, my name is Naomi Bluehouse, and I have the honor of introducing Ms. Destiny Morgan, our keynote speaker for today. Ms. Morgan is a 2019 alumni of Ganado High School. Ms. Morgan has recently graduated from the Fort Lewis College. During her time at FLC, she was a residential assistant for 2 years and the Miss Joni Ambassador First Attendant 2021-22. During her first reign, her platform was to instill and promote resiliency through Black liberation and indigenous sovereignty. Ms. Morgan was also the president of the Black Student Union at Fort Lewis College. Among the many accomplishments of this young mind, Ms. Morgan is currently a staff writer of an upcoming TV series for Amazon Prime. Destiny's goal in continuing her education is to pursue a master's degree in psychology and practice art therapy. All of Ms. Morgan's hard work and accomplishments are guided toward providing more access for mental health services on the Navajo Nation for our people. Ms. Morgan's goal in life is eliminating the negative stigma around mental health and trying to help this great tribe and many like it heal from the trauma and hardship of the past and set an example for the youth, because without them, we have no future. And now, without further ado, I'd like to introduce Ms. Destiny Morgan.
Thank you, Naomi. Destiny Morgan Yinishia, Punanathi Nishle, Nakisle Bushes Chin, Sitnaji Dushate Auto Nakisle Dushanale, Akwit Ego Dinazan Nishle. Depends on the Inishta, communication design, do psychology bubble shah, Nadin do Nakisha Nakle, look on tails with Nasha. Before I begin, I wanted to ask the graduates if you're planning on going to Fort Lewis? No? Oh, okay, a couple, ooh, go Skyhawks. And is there any fellow Fort Lewis alumni in the building? All right, go Skyhawks. Alrighty, so graduates of 2023,
You finally made it to the finish line. I am so very proud of each and every one of you, and I know this was not easy to do. Believe me, I know. It is a great honor and privilege to speak to each and every one of you on your special day, a day making one of the most important accomplishments of your life to date. I remember being exactly where you all are today, 4 years ago to be exact, when I graduated from high school in 2019. I used to get on the Wind Rock Summit bus route and make that 30 minute commute to the high school on Highway 264. During my graduation 4 years ago, I was actually standing at this podium introducing our class salutatorian at that time. Now I am here again today seeing familiar and new faces of teachers, staff, and faculty. I am in the exact place, in the exact same spot to address the class of 2023 on your amazing day, and I feel so greatly honored, and thank you for having me here today. So as Diné people, we have taken Chief Miguelito's teachings to heart since the long walk of 1864 through 1868, when we were forcibly removed from our Diné Pequeña. Then we finally returned to our homelands after years of imprisonment. And Chief Miguelito remains one of the revolutionary leaders of us, and as we continue to climb that ladder. And growing up, education has always been emphasized in my family, and it still is to this day. I know from an early age that I wanted to go to college and follow the footsteps of my parents, my aunts, my uncles, and my late grandfather, Dr. Philip Bluehouse. Many of you probably knew Dr. Philip Bluehouse. You may have seen him at the Ganado Chapter House meetings, at the board meetings, rodeos, etc. And when he started out as an educator here at Ganado Unified School District, he became a principal and then ultimately became a superintendent of this school district. And while he was teaching here at Ganado Unified School District, he considered each and every one of his students his grandchildren. And I always take that to heart because he wanted the best for everyone to pursue their education and further themselves. As a matter of fact, he loved education so much, he became a superintendent at Chinle Schools. Even though he was wearing Chinle district attire at his job in Chinle, he still wore that maroon underneath that Chinle attire. When I heard that story about my grandfather, I learned to never forget your roots and where you come from. Staying rooted in your hometown and community can establish a strong foundation of who you are as a person, no matter where you are. You know the famous quote by Chief Miguelito, as it says, "My Navajo people, education is a ladder to happiness. Go and climb that ladder." So graduating from Ganado High School, it opened so many doors for me and I experienced so many new opportunities. And when I got to Fort Lewis College, even more doors and more opportunities opened for me after that. So while at Fort Lewis, I was studying graphic design and sociology. I was going back and forth with myself of what I wanted to pursue my career in and what I wanted to study. I've dropped and added so many different majors and minors throughout my years. And I'm here to tell you, it is okay to switch between majors and minors because you are trying to figure out what your passions are. So, after going back and forth of what I wanted to study at Fort Lewis College, I finally decided to study graphic design and psychology with a minor in marketing because I found a passion for advocating for more mental health services and eliminating that negative stigma that surrounds that, and I want to be part of that change in the near future. So, during my years at Fort Lewis, I was an RA for 2 years. And for those that do not know what an RA is a residential assistant. So basically you're like a big sister or big brother to the whole campus community. And you have to, be their resource for every question that they ask. So you're kind of responsible for all of these young students like in the dorm building. And that's what I ultimately wanted to do, is to be more inclusive and invite everyone that felt like they were an outsider. And I hope this message translates with you today. Also during my time at Fort Lewis, I ran for the Miss Ojoni First Attendant during the 2021-2022 year. And my platform and my message I wanted to share as Miss Ojoni was instilling resilience in our Native community and the whole town of Durango, Colorado. And now, during my years at college, it was during my first year, I was a freshman, and that's when I was recently hired to be a staff writer for an upcoming TV series for Amazon Prime. So doing all of these things, putting myself out there, it was really amazing, and I felt so blessed and so honored to be able to go through all of these things. But then at the same time, doing all of these opportunities was terrifying. It was really scary. I am not gonna lie about that. I had so many thoughts of self-doubt. I was thinking to myself, I don't think I can handle this, or what if I fail? And I'm just a kid from the reservation, like there's no one else like me. So I had so many self-doubts. I had those situations where I kept talking myself out of these amazing opportunities. And then there was a point during my academic career when I considered dropping out of undergrad just to come home, because that's the only place I feel comfortable in and what I'm most familiar with. And that is also what I noticed too with everyone else that had graduated before me. They graduated high school from the reservation, and then they go off to pursue their dreams, to go to college, to move off the reservation. And then after a year later, I noticed them that they would return home so fast because of how things are so different, because you might get homesick or there's not people like you out there. And I'm here to tell you that it is okay to be afraid. You do not have to, you know, pretend to be brave all the time. It is okay to be scared, because when you have that feeling of feeling scared or nervousness, it means that you care a lot, and that is a great trait to have with you forever. So now you're probably wondering, Destiny, how did you overcome those thoughts of self-doubt? How did you motivate yourself to finish? I had to do a lot of self-reflection and ask myself, what am I here for? What is my ultimate purpose in life? I then thought of my family, my younger siblings and cousins, of how they look up to me and how they get excited seeing me when I come home during the holidays from college. And I thought of those little faces and I said to myself, that is what I'm going to school for. That is what I am going to school for, is to set an example and be a role model for the future generations that come after us. I also thought of my Grandpa Phil, who emphasized to put yourself out there, because you'll never know what you'll get into and the people that you will meet. And my Grandpa Phil always said it best, education is the answer. So what I'm here to share with you is, don't let fear hold you back from experiencing the glorious opportunities presented and destined for you. Because imposter syndrome is the greatest enemy of yourself. You are meant to belong and take up the space as young, brown, Diné peoples. Even when introducing yourself in your native language, introducing yourself in Diné Kedje, you are taking up the space that is meant for you. So never stop being yourself and take up the space that you meant to. Oftentimes, the mind is flooded with realizations that were, for some reason, harder to come when you were starting this academic climb of the ladder. At this moment, most of you need some realizations, because right now you have some big decisions to make. I don't want to scare you, but the future is bright for all of you. So right now, I urge you, in your breath, in your eyes, in your consciousness, to invest in the importance of this moment and cherish it. And I know some of you probably partied the night before today. I know I did when I was graduating. But the words of the great late Chadwick Boseman, he said, savor the taste of your triumphs today. Don't just swallow the moment whole without digesting what has actually happened here. Look down over what you conquered and appreciate what God has brought you through. And with that quote really resonated with me going through my years of undergrad and trying to find myself. And I want to bring back the point that I made when I was a title holder back in Fort Lewis, sharing my message of instilling resiliency in our Native communities especially. And I am here to tell you that each and every one of you here, graduates of 2023, you are resilient. I mean this with my whole heart. You all are resilient. To my student athletes, you have put in the commitment every practice to improve your skills. Coming home late from those away games that were 3 to 4 hours away every game and going to school at 7 a.m. Trust me, I was there and that was not easy. So I implore you for the efforts that you made to have you come onto this moment today. You have put in that work and you are resilient. To my AP and honor students, many of you have put in the many hours of prepping for your AP exams, taking on the extra commitments for studying, solving problems in AP calculus, and reading more books for AP Lit. You have put in that work and you are resilient. My regular students who are just doing your thing like you always have, going to school and then coming home to do homework and then coming back the next day to do it all over again. This was part of your regular routine. Everything was normal until we were all hit with the COVID-19 pandemic. And I know this pandemic has disrupted your routine and there was a lot of uncertainty about what happened next. But all of you have handled this terrifying situation with full grace and you have put in the work. You are resilient and you made it. And I really implore all of you, all of the staff and teachers that had to make the sudden adjustments just to keep everyone safe and while trying to teach and everyone of you to instill your minds, to enlighten your imaginations. I implore the staff and faculty. I also implore you parents and families that are here with your graduates today, because it must have been scary to send your child out there while this pandemic was going on. You put your whole trust into this school district to guide them, to stimulate their minds, to help them figure out what they want to do in life while navigating this life post-pandemic. So I implore everyone, each and every one of you, and can we get a round of applause for everyone that has made it to this day? And on my way here, there was a statistic that I read about for the graduation rate of Native American students for high school. So this is the statistic I found. As of 2022, the average four-year high school graduation rate for Native students is 72%. All of you here, graduates, you are here to add to that number. And our next objective is to get that number to 100%. So graduating class of 2023, hear me well on this day. When you have reached the top of the ladder, you are deciding your next jobs, your next steps, your next career and further education. You would rather find purpose than a job or career, because purpose crosses disciplines and purpose is an essential element of each and one of you. It is the reason you are on this earth in this particular time in history. Your very existence is wrapped up in the things that you are here to fulfill. Whatever you choose for a career path, remember the struggles along the way are only meant to shape you for your purpose. When God has something for you, it doesn't matter who stands against it. God will move someone that's holding you back away from the door and put someone there who will open it for you if it's meant for you. I don't know what your future is, but if you are willing to take the harder way, the more complicated one, the one with more failures than successes at first, the one that has ultimately proven to have more meaning, more victory, more glory, then you will not regret it. I promise you that. Now this is your time. The light of new realization shines on you. As you commence to your paths, press on with pride and press on with purpose. I know you are making your families, your communities, and yourselves proud as you continue to create a more equitable and just society as you uplift the multidimensional identities you may come across along the way. Nihith Achine, Nihith Ota, Nihith Natani, our children, our school, our future leaders, As the saying goes, it takes a village to raise a child. That saying is still true to this day. As you all here celebrating this special moment proves that it takes a whole nation to raise a child. Today is an extremely special day. Class of 2023, graduates and families, from one Ganado alumni to another, congratulations to each and every one of you. As this time of your life can feel like something is ending, y'all better strap your shoes on tight, because it is the very beginning of a life of mystery, enchantment, and many adventures that will take you beyond Highway 264. I love you, Ganado. Go Hornets. Again, in this tango do a da hoya. Thank you very much, Destiny, for your words shared with our class and with our graduating class here today. Thank you very much. You certainly are a role model for our students, and you've demonstrated through your success that the community of Ganado possesses many talented individuals, and many of you graduates will become utilize those talents and become successful yourselves. So there's a lot to look forward to. Ms. Morgan's speech reminded me also that this graduating class has definitely seen a lot more challenges than most graduating classes have had throughout their years of high school. Each year, beginning with their ninth grade year, has been interrupted. Their ninth grade, 10th grade, and 11th grade year. Their senior year has been the only full year of school that they have had. And all of these students are to be commended for sticking with it and making it here today, despite those challenges that all of us, the entire world, experienced. So congratulations again, graduating class. You did a very good job. At this time, I would like to recognize 10 outstanding seniors of Ganado High School. Our students have had many accomplishments in their years here at Ganado High School. Their educational goals have resulted in high academic achievements, and today these students are being introduced as the top 10 students of the class of 2023. Would these seniors please come to the stage to be recognized? Shelly Begay. Natile Tabaha. Ashton Apache. Shandine Benali. Eliana Smith. Emily Nez. Asha Linton. Kiara Curtis. Calista Shepherd. And Lissandre Baldwin.
These students have achieved the highest GPAs of their class, and we'd like to congratulate them on their achievements. We wish you all continued success in the years to come. Congratulations, everyone. Thank you. Next, I invite Ms. Shandine Benalim, the 2023 National Honor Society President, to the stage to recognize those seniors who have been a part of the National Honor Society chapter at Ganado High School. These seniors exemplify the four pillars of the National Honor Society and are wearing the signature gold stole, blue, and blue and gold honor cord. The blue stole, I'm sorry. Ms. Shandine Benalim will provide the recognition.
God is a Shandine Benalim Nisha. It's only in the Shlaki Ani Bashishi, when the Rani Bashiche, Ashimi Bashimale, Beke Baho Zamete Nasha.
I am the National Honor Society President, and I would like to take this time to recognize and thank the senior members of National Honor Society. These students who are now graduating have expressed academic devotion by maintaining at least a 3.0 GPA and community service hours with Honor Society or within their own time. As they graduate, I hope in later years that they will continue to pursue academics and community service. These members are Secretary of National Honor Society, Naomi Bluehouse. Lissandre Baldwin. Shelly Begay. Kiara Curtis. Alyssa Shepherd. Eliana Smith. Deandre Anderson. Ashton Apache. Sienna Holiday. Asha Linton. Emily Nez. Again, round of applause for all the National Honor Society members.
Thank you, Shandine, for that recognition of your peers. And this was the first year that we had one of the largest National Honor Society chapters here at Ganado High School in recent years. So congratulations to all those students for their recognition. And we do look forward to great things from you and hope that you continue to exemplify those four pillars. Next, I would like to invite Ms. Sarah Wilson, Ganado High School English teacher, to the stage to introduce this year's class of 2023 salutatorian.
Good afternoon. I have had the privilege of teaching your students for the last 2 years, or rather they've had me for 2 years. So, I had originally planned to give a long list of our salutatorians' long list of extraordinary academic accomplishments, her 3.81 GPA, her high batting average, her volleyball skills, and even throw in that she was a semifinalist in the coveted Gates Millennial Scholarship. Because it makes an excellent and amazing story. but I'm not going to highlight that. We all know that I can tell a really good story for a very long time, and we don't have the time. So, what I am going to highlight is how warm, kind, witty, and what an amazing example she is of what a Ganado student and what our future actually inhabits. It is my incredible honor to introduce to you the 2023 graduating class salutatorian, Calista Shepherd.
Як еш е Калиста Шепердинш я Цуцуниш но Сабаха Башиштин Сабаха Дешиче Сенджикин Дешинелли. Welcome parents, guardians, students, staff, and faculty members. I am happy you could join us today to witness one of life's greatest achievements for the class of 2023. When I was 5, I wished to be 10, seeing as if it were double digits. When I was 10, I wished to be 13, as I was officially a teenager. When I was 13, I wished to be 18, a full-grown adult. Now I'm 18, wishing to be 13, wishing to be 10, wishing to be that 5-year-old once again. All the years of hard work and dedication have finally paid off, as I spent most of my time being a part of great programs such as National Honor Society, Student Council, FCCLA, Talent Search, and NACEP. They brought me new opportunities and helped me seek leadership roles. I had the chance to meet such amazing young people and future leaders. As I've grown to learn that labels and titles work, but I have also realized how they don't determine who you become. The work and effort you put in behind the scenes determine the person you truly are. I am very proud to come from a long background of strong leaders who have set forth high standards and who've played a bigger role in raising me, my parents. I might not say it as much, but I'm very appreciative for all the support you've shown me effortlessly. Dealing with a sassy 5-year-old girl who cried over the smallest things, I believe I had more mental breakdowns as a 3-year-old. So thank you, Mom and Dad, for putting up with me. We've all had our ups and downs, but you taught me a very valuable lesson and told me to cherish every single moment as I take this big step into adulthood. Whoever that person may be that's cheering you on from the corner or the sidelines, I urge you, class of 2023, to thank them, as they've sacrificed so much to see you smile and to live the best possible life. I encourage you to remember where you came from and know that you have a place in this world. As I always been taught from a young age, that our mom, our dad, our grandparents, our nollies won't be here for long to tell us what's right from wrong. Life will throw rocks at you and bumps along the road. I want to share one of life's toughest challenges. In my case, it was a setback not long ago. As many of you may know, I was a candidate in the running for the Gates Millennium Scholarship, a full-ride scholarship to any choice of my school. I started my journey in July of 2022 and ended in April of this year. Sadly, I fell short and made the top 600 out of 3,000 candidates. I have plans to attend the University of Arizona coming this fall semester,
It's been a great struggle to see a clear path, and I've changed course several times and contemplated different majors within the past month, which is okay. My advice to you is this: never let fear decide your fate, as it is okay to fail and fall on your face. It's okay to take chances and make sacrifices. It's okay if life isn't great as we tend to lose ourselves in certain estates. It's okay if high school wasn't perfect, because beyond these walls stands a greater challenge. Our first steps into this new world awaits, whether that be college, moving, or a new job. It's a saying that high school flies by in a blink of an eye. I didn't realize how true that was until now. Standing here in front of you all, as we gather here for one last time to say goodbye to teachers and friends, we look back on the memories we've made and the lessons we've learned along the way. We've learned to fly with the guidance of teachers who've shown us the way and the support of classmates who've brightened each day. Here's to the teachers who've inspired us and to the classmates who've been there through it all. We've laughed, we've cried, we've worked our butts off to see this final day. We've challenged ourselves in so many ways as we say goodbye and go our separate ways. We'll hold on to the memories created. We have a lot to be proud of, and we have a lot to look forward to. The future is bright, but that's up to you. This day was set to come for our final goodbye of the class, the roaring class of 2023. We walked the same path, but got on different shoes, a little line from the man himself, Drake. But congratulations, class of 2023.
Thank you, Calista, for that wonderful speech. She definitely has an excellent path set for herself, and we wish her continued success in all of the things that she chooses to do. So congratulations, Calista. Next, I would like to invite Ms. Claire Poole, Ganado High School Senior Economics and Government teacher, to the stage to introduce this year's class of 2023 valedictorian.
Hello. It is with my great pleasure that I get to introduce our valedictorian for the class this year. She is literally the senior, the best at going the distance, a true overachiever in every sense of the word. She literally never gave up, continuing completely as far as she could, doing everything she can. She took tests multiple times, like she had an 89% in Ingenuity one of her classes and retook some of her tests just so she could get that A. I kept trying to get her to give up. She had an A for the semester, but not the quarter. I was like, come on, just... She literally could not be stopped. She is the only senior with over a 4.0 GPA this year. Only one. And she even has a 4.14, so really overachieving on that. I present to you, Ganado, your 2023 valedictorian, Lissandre Baldwin.
Good afternoon, everyone. I like to give a thanks to all the administrators, teachers, family, friends, faculty, staff for putting this all together for us today. My nishki zinishle, so sohni, bashishin, the bethajin, deshache, torichini, deshanella. I am originally from Klagato, but I reside in Nazlini. I wish I have not received this award today as valedictorian just because I dreaded this moment of giving a speech to you all. But I always wanted to be the valedictorian because I would listen to valedictorians and keynote speakers from previous graduation ceremonies here in this pavilion. I am proud to be your valedictorian this year. I am very honored to give a speech to you all today. I am very proud to be standing here and giving this speech and having my parents, here, as in when I was little, as in 4 years, when I was 4 years old, I would sit on my Nolly's couch and I would read the Magic Treehouse books and Shortcuts and Boots. I would like to give a round of thank you to my parents here today. I would like to thank each family member who has came today, who have taken the time to come and watch and celebrate our accomplishments today as the class of Ganado High School, class of 2023. I would like to congratulate each and every one of you here who has made it. The time we spent on each assignment, looking at a screen, filling out paperwork, and asking each other for help. Look at us now, we made it. There has always been a person, or multiple, you could say, who have watched us closely on our journey to know every little single thing about us, even those funny cringe moments. The ones who do so much out of the way to provide for us. The ones we ask the most weirdest questions you can think of that may surprise them, as in, how did they know that? Or, I didn't even know that. One question my little sister always asked my parents and my aunties and uncles is, where do babies come from? They wouldn't give us the real answer at that age, but they always take their time to tease us. And those moments we cherish deeply and reflect on now. As in Calista said, we wish to be 5 years old again. We wish to have those moments again. I would thank all the parents, mentors, teachers, staffs, or those who took a role model as a parent to each and every one of us here. Ayahat, thank you so much. To those who are unfortunate to be with us here today, our loved ones, in spirit, they are present today, looking down on your accomplishments of your achievements. I would like to quote from 2019 class motto. It goes, "You may not always have a comfortable life, and you will not always be able to solve all the world's problems all at once. But don't underestimate the impact you can have, because history has shown us that courage can be contagious, and hope can take on life of its own." And this is from Michelle Obama herself. You today, class of 2023, have been able to be an inspiration to someone today or these past few years. Keep carrying on with your life. If it's carrying on with your education, going to military, trade school, or getting a job. But when you make your decision, make sure you're happy with what you're going with. Someone once told me. We have each struggled over the past years, mentally, physically, emotionally, but we have overcame it and became stronger. Continue to learn each day, even if it's the smallest thing you can think of. Remember one another, because relationship and bond is what has brought us together today. My sister in the Navy once told me, grow where you are planted. because you are able to seek out other people to invest in your life. So you can tell your stories to those who look up upon you as the generations and yourself flourish in the progression of life. But yeah, and I would like to thank my parents again for every little single thing that you have done for me, from driving me to practice, picking me up, going to my meets, coming to my awards, and all the moments of troubles and triumphs. Ashton would call them my tribe. She would be like, everybody would ask me a question saying, how many siblings do you have? And I would be, I have 15. Ashton would be like, that's not a family, that's a tribe, what do you mean? But yeah, thank you Ashton for being a very big impact on my life. My parents and my family are my tribe. I would like to congratulate each and every one of you of giving me the courage and the mentality to be here, standing here today to get my work done, because education is very, not strict in my family, but like they tell you, education, 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 because my dad did not get an education and my mom, but they are here with me today. I would like to give a big thanks to these people. Sorry. I would utterly give thanks to these people. Shandine, showing me it's okay to struggle. Ashton, showing me everyone has their flaws, but it doesn't make them imperfect. Koi, showing me and witnessing myself that goals can be accomplished. Micah, showing me the hard work pays off and having strong faith in yourself. Kiara, showing me it's okay to laugh during the hardest moments in your life. Kalissa, we don't have to do what others are told to do. My coaches from cross country these past few years, I shared a journey with Koi and Micah since fifth grade. They have shown me to grow as a person mentally each day, that discipline is very well indeed in life. Getting up in the morning is very stressful to me because I am not a morning person, but my dad would always tell me, get up in the morning, pray for yourself, do this. It's all upon yourself to make a decision. And I would like to thank Alina, who has always been there for me and given me the positive energy I need. Chantel, to enjoy the moments. To Desert, that people come into your life for a season. Miss Cool, that it's never too late at all. You can start today, tomorrow, the next week, it's never too late. And that all teachers are not bad. Miss Wilson, who has given me to look at other people's perspective and not just mine. My aunties and uncles, who have I visit this past weekend to give my invitations, that they have told me today to speak from my heart and give words of wisdom to you all. To know where you come from, to be proud of yourself, to be proud of everything you do, and to have a courage in your life to do something, and to tell yourself you can do it, believe in yourself. My grandpa, who is not here today, but he has told me that dreams do come true. My Nolly, that where you are today and tomorrow is where you're supposed to be. My track team friends and fellow teammates have made me laugh over the past year and have the most exciting track team this year. Kirsten, Randon, and Natasha. Thank you, Grant, too. My track coaches has given me a little support And over the past failures I had this year of having injuries to deal with, they have given me that you have a heart to run. My basketball coach, Mr. Todicini, who has his phone up right now, recording me, that take your ambitions to go after your goal because someone else has a goal just like you. And they're pushing just as hard as you, but who wants it more? I would like to thank my siblings, Malik, Lashana, Maria, Linnea, Romeo, Lintel, Tavia, Caden, Hart, Noel, Rosemary,
Isaac.
Thank you for all the moments we enjoy to each other, even when we go grocery shopping, laughing at one another, making jokes. And my brother Romeo, who's always trying to rip somebody up in the grocery store. Thank you so much. Thank you to all the parents who came here today to celebrate your kid, your grandkids, your niece, your nephews, of graduating today, which is the biggest accomplishment in their lives. They have went through the hard work, they have done it, and they are ready to get their diploma. And I would like to give a little reminder today that you should write your own story. Don't let anybody tell you what to do. It is your life. You choose to make the decisions yourself. Life is a puzzle, but when you put it together, you will see the masterpiece that it made for you. Thank you.
Congratulations, Lissandri, for receiving the Ganado High School's highest academic honor as class valedictorian. Congratulations. I know that she values very much her family as well as her friends, and definitely they all share in her accomplishments here today and beyond high school as well. So thank you all for your support of our top two students here today. Next, we have the Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company presentation of a scholarship and award. Mr. Leonard L. Sosi is the chairman of the board, and he has Representative William McCabe here to recognize our class valedictorian and salutatorian. I welcome Mr. McCabe to the podium.
Thank you, Madam Principal. Yacht A, Ganado Hornets, class of 2023. Congratulations, give yourself a hand. Yacht A, William McCabe, Nishe, Tachidi, Nishle, Ashiti Bashishin, Fashiti Dashiche, Aro, Maitashkiri Dashanelli. My name is Bill McCabe. I'm the Vice President for the Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company, and I'm very honored to be here among such achievement. And on behalf of the board of directors, the employees of the company, our management, our executive staff, I want to acknowledge the achievements of the class of 2023, but more so the achievements of the salutatorian, Callista Shepherd. We have a certificate of scholarship here. It's in honor of outstanding performance. And the scholarship award for excellence. So if I could have you come up here. A scholarship check for your further endeavors. And actually, just hold on a second. And of course, the highest achievement for academic excellence with regard to GPA. The Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company is greatly pleased and honored to present this certificate of scholarship in honor of outstanding performance to Ms. Baldwin of the valedictorian class of 2023. Thank you for your hard work, your achievement, going above and beyond 4.0. So, oh, you're waiting for something.
Okay.
I'm going to hand you this. Not a big story. And again, thank you so much for your achievements. It's an honor to be on the stage with you. And again.
Congratulations, girls. Thank you very much, Mr. McKay from the Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company. Congratulations, girls. Next, I would like to invite to the podium the Apache County School Superintendent, Ms. Joy Whiting.
I just want to give an award in recognition to Lissandra Baldwin, if she could come back up here. Sorry about that. It's an honor and a privilege from Apache County Superintendent's Office to award her a Chromebook for her achievements and her good efforts for being the valedictorian of Ganado High School 2023. Thank you so much. Congratulations again. Thank you.
Well, that will definitely come in handy for Lissandra as she moves on to higher education. Everybody needs a laptop if they're going off to any type of school. So that, thank you very much, Ms. Whiting, for being here to present that to her. Now we come to the time in our program to honor all members of the class of 2023. I'd like to invite Superintendent Thomas to the podium. Superintendent Thomas, it is with honor and privilege that I present to you these students. I certify that these students have met the graduation requirements set forth by the State of Arizona and the Ganado Unified School District Governing Board. I now request the confirmation of their graduation. Would the class please stand?
By the authority vested in me as the Ganado Unified School District Superintendent, and by the virtue of the certification made by your principal, Ms. Lucille Sidney, that you have successfully completed all the requirements of the basic educational curriculum of the Ganado Unified School District, I hereby confirm your graduation this 26th day of May, 2023. This diploma is awarded to you with all of the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining therefore. Congratulations.
Mrs. Loretta Smith will call the roll for the presentation of diplomas. Mrs. Smith was the senior class sponsor for a time and is a PE health teacher here at Ganado High School.
Thank you.
Parker.
It is my honor. Deandre Anderson. Ashton Apache. Kaskoli Adakai. Lasandre Nicole Baldwin. Shanoa Vicente. Yeah. April LaVeya Begay.
Did they say when there's three left, right?
Artesia Ray Begay. Begay. Damien Begay. Liberty Begay. Randall Begay Jr. Shelly Begay. Shandine Sage Benali. Shada Baya. Logan Billy. Naomi Shandine Bluehouse. Kiana Brown. Mia Lane Chi. Natalia Chi. Markel Thomas Edison. Tanner Guy.
Kanisha James. James. Brianna Zani Jim. Aldandria Lena Jody. Alessandria Jody. Fiera John. Donovan Key. Caitlin King. Tamia DeShine King. Ewan Lau. Mariah Lee. Colson Luke. Mariano Luther. Selena Mendoza. Deshaun Jaquez Moore. Dakota Mole. Mariah Naminha. Joss Nelson. Emily Ann Nez. Sinead Preston. Alina Oliveria Reed. Reed. Calista Bell Shepherd. Marissa Shardy. Micah Slivers. Eliana Andrea Cheyenne Smith. Alexia Nanaba Smith. Jackson, Jack Thomas. Natile Tabaha. Tyverson Tracy. Chantel Talia Sosi.
To request Callista Shepherd and Lissandre Baldwin, please return to the stage. At this time, I'd like to bestow upon our class salutatorian, Ms. Callista Shepherd, the salutatorian award presented to Callista Shepherd in recognition of your outstanding academic achievement in receiving the second highest breakpoint average of the class of 2023, awarded this 26th day of May, 2023. I would also like to bestow upon Lissandre Baldwin the Valedictorian Award in recognition of your outstanding academic achievement in receiving the highest grade point average of the class of 2023, awarded this 26th day of May, 2023. I would like to welcome to the stage Mr. Robert Berkey, Ganado High School senior math teacher, to lead the class of 2023 in the turning of the tassel. Would the class of 2023 please stand?
Thank you for my name is Mr. Berkey. I am their math teacher. I have been up here on this part of the state for 19 years, so it's been a while. I've been here for 7 years, so it's, thank you for letting me share this ceremony with you. And I'm honored that you chose me to for this role. Many words have been said about this day of celebration. You've received your diploma, which is a symbol of your hard work. But as an outward sign of this event, how you wear your tassel is part of what you need to show. You came in here wearing it on the right, and you will leave wearing it on the left. Graduates, turn your tassel from the right to the left. Class of 2023, congratulations. Diego!
Thank you, Mr. Berkey. The class may now be seated, and members of the platform may be seated. To provide our closing remarks to the class, please welcome Ms. Liberty Begay, class of 2023 graduate.
First thing I would like to say is thank you to those that made it possible for me to come up here. And I was told like maybe a week before, and I did write a script, but the problem is that's how I was feeling at the time. And I want this to come more from the heart. And looking at all of you now, it's crazy because I grew up with many of you. And it's funny because also I look around and I also see people like waving themselves down. I know a lot of you want to get out of here probably. So I'm going to try to make this quick. This last year has been really amazing. All these 4 years, I've gotten to know most of you. And even in this last year, I've met some of you just this year. Some of you I've known practically my whole life. And I'd like to say thank you to all of our classmates. All of you have helped me in some way, even if it was something small. And I know that most of you can say the same, that we've all helped each other. And I'm not going to tell you guys to move forward with your education, seeing as how many of you guys have struggled with it. But I'm going to tell you to move forward with your life and do good with it. Get a job, whatever it is that you want. And I'm not telling you to, as people have said, you know, the only way to life is education. That's not the way I see things. I see the way that you handle your life. If you do good, then that's the way you should do it. And also, I'd like to thank my parents. My parents have given me every opportunity to be up here. And to all of you other parents, I'm sorry, I'm getting emotional. My parents have been up here, been with me this whole entire time and have supported me endlessly. It's time to say goodbye, you know? But
the same time, I'm happy to see all of you go. I'm happy to see all of you move forward. I'm happy to see my own friends move on. Ashton, DeAndre, Colson, Fiera, Rebecca, and LaDainian. You have given me the best experience this whole entire time. And I'm happy to see all of you go now. And finally, thank you to all my teachers. At first, I wanted to thank all of them one by one, but all of them have all taught us one thing, and mainly, the way I see it, they've really been patient with all of us. And, well, they've been patient with us this whole entire time, seeing as how our class went from only 20 to 30 to 40, and now seeing all of you here graduate. And I kept telling myself, I'm like, I'm not gonna cry, but I did, and but that's it, I'm happy to see all of you go. And I hope all of you are able to move forward and make good decisions with your life. Thank you.
Thank you, Liberty. At this time, I'd like to recognize the teaching staff and other educational staff of Ganado High School. At the rear of the floor back there, you stand up and give a wave, and all the graduates, please thank your teachers and other staff for being there for you. We also have teachers up here on the stage as well. Ganado High School has a very talented and kind staff, and many of them have grown to know the graduates here throughout their 4 years of high school and have supported them in many ways. Again, we congratulate the class of 2023 on this achievement of earning your high school diploma. In closing of our commencement exercises today, I extend to you a sincere well wishes to you all in your pursuits beyond high school, whatever that they may be. Always remember that Ganado High School is your home and you are welcome back anytime. Thank you very much. Families and guests, please join us in celebration of the class of 2023 as they exit the pavilion. Congratulations. Thank you for your presence and safe travels to all of you. Graduates will exit.
Backstage.